Hey, welcome back to part three of my gaming library. In case you missed the first two on Wii and GameCube, I'll post some annotations right now for you. But if you want to watch this one's going to be on my PS2 collection. Now, this one is actually going to be shorter than the other ones because I only have nine of them here. So, yes, I know. But let's go ahead and get started on these ones right here. All right, first one here is Dead or Alive 2 Hardcore. I remember I picked up this one used for like $9 at GameStop, and it's a fun fighter. I really do like it a lot. And I actually just recently played this a couple nights ago in anticipation of Dead or Alive Dimensions for the 3DS later this month, so great game, I really do love it. Next is Tekken Tag Tournament. Now, this one I have to say is my favorite Tekken game to date. I'm not too certain about Tekken Tag 2, but this one is, I really do like this one a lot. I remember my best friend bringing this over when I got a PS2 back in 04, and I remember having a lot of fun playing it because I love the tag team concept a lot. So I ended up buying my own copy finally. I think I paid like $7 for it. Pretty cheap at the time. Next one is gotta be my favorite. Definitely my favorite 2D fighter, but I'm gonna say my favorite fighting game ever. Capcom versus SNK2. Now, this is the fighter right here that got me into fighting games. Okay, this is the fighter right here that basically turned me into an avid fighting game fan. I picked it up kind of out of complete almost nowhere for like $30. At the time, actually, it was about a couple months beforehand. I bought in Marvel vs. Capcom 2 for the PS2. Paid a pretty penny for that thing, but I found this one for $30 used at GameStop, and I can't say that I can play a better fighting game than this right here. The only thing I hope Capcom does is put this as a downloadable title on PSN and Xbox Live. They better put it on PSN, because if they've been pulling what SNK's been doing and putting other games on Xbox Live only, I might actually get pissed. Maybe not. I don't know. We'll see what happens. All right, next one is Guilty Gear X2. This one is also a pretty badass fighting game. I love it. The 2D anime graphics, the killer soundtrack, the wicked combos you can pull off in this game. I remember playing. I used to have a Guilty Gear Advanced Edition on Game Boy Advance. I loved that one a lot. And I picked up this one in like 2006, I think it was. Yeah, 2006. I think I picked it up like a few weeks after CVS2. But yeah, I picked this one up, and this one was great. I loved it just because it was so badass, And I love the soundtrack by that. Daisuke Ishiwatari is probably my second favorite music composer, and only one right behind. Well, he's only right behind Koji Kondo, of course. Next up is Burnout Revenge. Now, this one I remember picking up when it just hit the greatest hits for $20, and actually, I believe my sister got this for me, kind of as like a late birthday present. But I loved it though. It was very fast-paced, very arcadey, and not to mention just taking down your opponents was so much fun. It was great, but unfortunately at the time I did not have any online play. And then when I finally got my PS3, which had backwards compatibility, I wanted to try this online, but EA already shut the servers down. I was a little saddened by that. But oh well. All right. Continuing is The King of Fighters 2006. I remember picking this one up in the bargain bin actually for $15, half the price they wanted to go for. And I remember playing it once at a friend's house. I thought it was pretty good. And I actually bought it around the same time as a Resident Evil 4 Wii Edition. And I figured, $15, why not? Let's give it a shot. And I was heavily surprised by this game. It was quite amazing, actually. Very fast paced. Characters look really good in 3D. I played in Maximum Impact 1, which was like, absolutely terrible. It was not that great. But this one was a big improvement upon it. And I like it, though. And then they say King of Fighters should never go 3D. I think they did a good job on this one. All right, next one, I guess you could say is like, oh, I gotta put this. What's the term they use? The black sheep of fighting games? Not so well known, but I picked it up before myself, though. Arcana Heart. This one I remember getting back in like April of 08, like when it first came out, actually, for $30. I have to say, this is actually a pretty good little fighting game. You know, the thing you have to know is that it's an all-female fighting game. There's no male characters. In fact, I don't think you even see a male character once in this game, as far as I'm concerned. But, yeah, if you look at the back cover, some of the characters there and stuff. Yeah, this is actually a pretty fun little fighter, though. I really did like it a lot, and, you know, they never released Arcana Heart 2 out here in America, but they just recently put it on PSN, and thank God before PSN went down, I downloaded Arcana Heart 3. So, I have that too, but Arcana Heart was a good fighter. Next is Neo Geo Battle Coliseum. This is also another little gem of a fighter. Kind of somewhat known on PS2, but not so well known. It kind of has that Marvel vs. Capcom style, except it's all SNK characters. You know, from Samurai Showdown, World of Heroes, Metal Slug, King of Fighters. I thought it was pretty good, though, actually. Now, I know they released it again on, on Xbox Live with online play, which I'm a little disappointed by because I wanted that on PSN as well. And what I mentioned before about Capcom vs. SNK2, if it went to Xbox Live only, it's because of this game, Garou: Mark of the Wolves, and I think it was like King of Fighters 98, that all three of those games went to Xbox Live only with online play, and I'm actually disappointed by that because I don't have an Xbox 360 to play those, and they all have online play, which is something I really want. And the last game, I know, pretty sure this one, wasn't it? King of Fighters 11. I picked this one up about a little less than a year ago for, believe it or not, I think I got it off Amazon, actually. It was brand new, steel seals and everything. I believe the shipping was more than the game. I paid like $250 for the game and like $299 for shipping. So I essentially paid about $550 for this, brand new, sealed and everything. And this is probably my favorite King of Fighters to date. And I do mean that. I do mean that though, because King of Fighters 12 was, ugh. I'm not even gonna get started on that game, but King of Fighters 12 was a humongous letdown. Hopefully 13 will be a whole lot better. In fact, it looks like it's a lot better, but I can't wait to see what it's gonna be like at least. So there are my PlayStation 2 games. I know, not very many to go through. But the next part we will cover my PlayStation 3 games, so stay tuned for that.